There's a uniform that's hanging in what's known as Father's room. A uniform so simple in its style. It's got no braid of gold, no silk, no hat with feathered plume. Yet me mother has preserved it all the while. One day she made me try it on, a wish of mine for years. This in memory of your father, dear, she said. And when I put the sound brown on, she was smiling to her tears as she placed the broad black brimmer on me head. It's just a broad black brimmer, ribbon frayed and torn by the careless whisk of many's a mountain breeze. An old trench coat that's all battle-stained and worn, and breeches almost threadbare at the knees. A sand-brown belt with a buckle big and strong, and a holster that's been empty many's a day.
But not for long!
But when men claim Ireland's freedom, the one should choose to lead them will wear the broad black brimmer of the IRA. That's a uniform be worn by my father long ago, when he reached me mother's homestead on the run. It was the uniform be worn in that little church below, when good Father Mac could bless the Paris one. And after truce and treaty and the parting of the ways, he wore it when he marched out with the rest.
And the best!
And when they brought his body down on that rugged heather braes, they placed the broad black brimmer on his chest.
It's just a broad black brimmer, ribbon frayed and torn by the careless whisk of many's a mountain breeze. An old trench coat that's all battle-stained and worn, and breeches almost threadbare at the knees. A sand-brown belt with a buckle big and strong, and a holster that's been empty many's a day. But not for long!
But when men claim Ireland's freedom, the one should choose to lead them will wear the broad black brimmer of the IRA. But when men claim Ireland's freedom, the one should choose to lead them will wear the broad black brimmer of the IRA.